coming up on Pierce County News.
But we know today there are things that we can do today.
Homelessness is on the rise, warnings about lead in your soil, and a special clinic for horse owners. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radall. A new report finds the homeless population in Pierce County is growing by a lot. 37% more people are on the streets than last year. Greg McClellan looks at trends in the data and what that means for fighting the problem.
Pierce County released the numbers they gathered on January 29th for the annual point-in-time homeless count. It's a one-day snapshot of who is homeless and the data surrounding their situation. The report shows nearly 2,000 people were homeless that night in our county. More than 1,200 of them were in a shelter or temporary housing. Nearly 500 slept outside. There were 190 veterans, and 420 people had been homeless for more than a year.
The other striking increase that we noticed this year is among victims of domestic violence. So we found that since 2010, there's been a 160% increase in people who identify domestic violence, fleeing from domestic violence, or being survivors of domestic violence.
There is a growing concern and frustration that despite the current programs and services, homeless numbers are still on the rise. They're up 37% over last year's count, and the officials say more resources are needed.
We've done a number of strategies and ideas, and I've convened a number of bodies and folks and to address this issue. And I will tell you that we still need the resources to make it happen because we don't have them.
Resources like more shelters and more affordable housing. Nativity House in Tacoma has a day shelter where folks can get out of the weather and get a meal. But they also have a 50-bed women's shelter and 120 beds for men. Joseph has been homeless and says housing was the only thing that turned his life around.
These are the keys to freedom, the keys to success, and access to the whole world, because I had the fortune of getting one of the apartments upstairs, and I'm thankful for it.
Services like housing are costly to operate. The county is considering a new tax to pay for it, something other large counties and cities in our state are already doing.
One of the tools that we haven't used is passing a 0.1% sales tax. I know they're not popular, nobody wants to pay taxes, but we have a significant issue and we need every tool, every arsenal in our toolbox in which to address it.
The city of Tacoma gets about $9.5 million every biennium from that 0.1% sales tax. And we use that funding to help with a variety of services.
While that tax is a potential option, the county council is looking for additional ways to address the growing problem of homelessness.
The city of Tacoma and the county council have partnered to develop a permanent site for overnight shelter for young adults and youth. And in the meantime, we've committed to providing temporary shelter in the Beacon Senior Center and contributed about $100,000 in that effort.
The Pierce County Council will dig into the homeless report at its May 9th Public Safety and Human Services Committee meeting. And the results from a mental health study just underway to assess gaps in service will be out this September. Greg McClellan, Pierce County News.
There's a lot of concern about lead contamination in the water at some Tacoma schools and homes. But the Tacoma Pierce County Health Department warns you should also be thinking about more common ways you could be exposed to higher levels of lead. Back in 2014, all of the dirt in Tacoma's Basalt Park was replaced. Harmful amounts of arsenic and lead had spewed from a smelter on Ruston Way for nearly 100 years. That contamination was deposited in North Tacoma, Gig Harbor, University Place, and Lakewood.
If you haven't had your soil tested and you live in proximity to the old smelter, you can call the health department. We'll come out and test your soil to see if it contains arsenic and lead. And then if it does, potentially you could be eligible to have your yard cleaned up and the soil replaced.
DiBiase says it's important for people to think about the more common ways you might be exposed to lead. That's in your home soil and lead paint.
The most likely reason that a child will have an elevated blood lead level is because of an exposure to lead-based paint.
If you're outside in the yard, some tips are to wash your hands afterwards, remove your shoes at the door, wear gardening gloves when planting, and grow veggies in a raised bed with new dirt. Also, water lead testing in homes and schools continues as the Tacoma Pierce County Health Department helps other agencies.
The lead we're talking about isn't actually in the water source itself. Like, if you're served by Tacoma Water, you should feel fortunate, quite honestly, because they have some of the best water, safest water around, really, in the country. The challenge is with the infrastructure, the piping and the plumbing.
For more general information, visit the Health Department's website. The City of Fife has some major projects on the horizon that you should know about. They'll impact both people who live in the city and many more who commute through town. Joining me today is Mayor of Fife, Winston Marsh. Mayor, I understand you have an online tool that will help people actually look through your budget.
We do. A new tool is called Socrata. Enables our citizens to go to our website, drill down into our both our revenue and our expenses with our budget. It enables them to look both at a very high level, or if interested, they can drill down to a very, very fine minutia level to gather data.
And we all know that you have an interchange running right through your city. How will a new interchange project help congestion in the area?
Good question. As we know, anybody who's driven through I-5 or down I-5 on Fife realizes it's definitely is a pressure point. Our staff has worked on, I think, 9 different options to resolve the congestion that goes through that area. We've whittled it down to 4. Staff has done a great job. We have partners there that we're working with, Federal Highway Administration, WashDOT, Tribe, and Port of Tacoma.
And we understand that the Sound Transit 3 proposal is out, and there might be some rail projects slated for your area.
That's true. If approved by the voters this fall, SD3 will add about 58 miles of track, 38 new stations, one of which is in Fife. A huge impact for us. It'll enable us to, you know, easily reach, you know, heading north to Seattle and even south into Tacoma. It give us a huge improvement in movability in our city.
And a fun event coming up, Youth Recognition Night. Tell me about that.
Fife Youth Commission is sponsoring their second annual recognition of students in the Fife School District, recognizing students from K through 12. I think there were 15 different nominations. Keynote speaker is David Bean from the Puyallup Tribe, very impressive individual.
That'll be fun to watch. So much going on. Thanks so much for coming in and talking about it.
Thank you. Thank you very much for having me.
It's not easy walking in someone else's shoes, especially if you're a man walking in high heels. However difficult it may be, many men took on the challenge for a great cause. Walkers sized up their feet for high heels and took the mile-long walk in downtown Tacoma to help raise awareness about sexual assaults in Pierce County. This is the 11th annual Walk a Mile in Her Shoes event held by the Sexual Assault Center for Pierce County. Executive Director Tasha Smith says the old saying, you can't understand another person's experience until you've walked in their shoes, sums up why these men walk.
Well, I'm surprised how many people turn out, but it's amazing. And, you know, hopefully each year we hope to do a little better and a little better. But just having men that are willing to give up their lunch hour and their heels to blisters, thanks to them.
Pierce County Prosecutor Scott Peters says this helps give victims a voice when it comes to sexual assault.
People are able to come forward afterwards. They feel comfortable and confident to report these types of crimes because for a long time these went unreported. And so they're coming forward, they're letting us know, they're letting police know. That gets investigations going and helps us in terms of prosecution.
More than 150 walkers participated in this year's walk and helped raise more than $21,000. A third generation of clouded leopards was welcomed to the Point Defiance Zoo family. The two males and one female were born March 30th, and because they're endangered, the staff at Point Defiance are excited about the rare birth. Handlers feed the triplet cubs six times a day. Just like a human newborn, those feedings begin in the early hours at 1 a.m. Education curator Karen Povey explains why it's important to introduce future mates when they're very young. It's a breeding program with a successful formula.
Historically, cloud leopards have been really challenging to breed, and there were very few litters born over the years. But one of the secrets that we have really figured out is that by putting them together when they're really young, they grow up developing a really positive relationship.
Also important, the triplets were born to first-time parents. The father, Tien, and his father were also born at Point Defiance, making this a rare third generation born in captivity.
When people come to visit, they get to see our cubs up really close. They live in our cub den, which is just a piece of glass that you can look through and see them being fed.
Visit the zoo's website for the latest times and information on when you can see the cubs on display in the Asian sanctuary. Coming up next, see how a free clinic is helping horse owners in Pierce County. We're back in just 60 seconds.
I'm Tim McGraw, and I have a challenge for you. Nearly 30 million Americans have diabetes. Most have type 2 diabetes. I've seen firsthand how it impacts people from all walks of life. It's affected my family, friends, and fans. If you have diabetes, take the challenge to get your blood sugar under control. Pledge to work with your doctor to set and reach your own A1C goal. I'm a strong believer in making healthy choices, so join me now at americasdiabeteschallenge.com.
Now you can see Pierce County from your phone or tablet with the new PCTV mobile app. Pierce County and City Council meetings, the weekly Pierce County News
on PCTV,
News Magazine Rainier Country, the topical discussions of Pierce County Talks, and all of the special programs in between. Download the app today and see Pierce County from here. PCTV, Pierce County Television. Pierce County has a problem with overpopulation. There are too many horses and not enough people to care for them. And animal control wants to prevent the careless breeding of horses. Megan Hutton is here to tell us about a creative solution to the problem.
Heather, it all started during the recession when horse owners couldn't afford to care for their animals, and we saw an increase in rescue horses. Now a free clinic is helping owners cover the cost of gelding.
No one likes to go to the hospital. Surgery is no fun.
We cut his food last night at midnight, and now he just feels like he's deprived. He's withering away to nothing.
2-year-old Whiskey was rescued off the Yakima Indian Reservation, and he's a handsome, healthy horse. There's just one problem.
On the farm where we've got him boarded, she's got a few girls, so it's kind of hard to keep them separated now.
So today, it's gelding day at the Frontier Park Horse Stables in Graham. The Pierce County Auditor's Office, which manages animal control, went after grant money to put on this free horse castration clinic.
It's part of our strategic plan is to reduce the number of horses that we're seizing. And one of the goals was castration clinic. So less stallions, less babies that can be made.
The reason we can do this is because Pierce County has a very concerned animal control group, and they really sought out funding to be able to provide for the citizens in the county, and that citizens shouldn't take that lightly. This is government doing something for them for free, which it's easy to bash the government, but in this case, it's a really great service that we provide to horse owners in Pierce County.
Horse owners like Terry Barber, she has two rescued miniature horses here today.
They can be aggressive, they can bite, they can strike, attack other horses, so that can, you know, harm you as well. So when you're looking at kids and people around there, it makes them more gentle, easier to work with, and especially if they've not had any training at all.
The word castration would understandably make any patient nervous, but the procedure is pretty quick.
They're given a drug that makes them go down to the ground and be asleep. We perform the procedure. It takes anywhere from 5 minutes to 20 minutes.
Think of it as a spay or a neuter for a dog. That's pretty much what we're doing. It's just larger scale. It's on a horse.
And as tough as it is on owners to watch their horses undergo abdominal surgery, they're thankful for the help.
For example, I just had my dog and the veterinarian for a simple cut in her ear, and it cost me $600. So I'm sure this would probably be a little more than that. So it's nice to have the, you know, the county help out.
After 45 minutes of recovery, Whiskey is back on his feet and he'll soon be ready to go home.
If you're interested in free horse castration clinics, call the Pierce County Auditor's Animal Control number at 253-798-PETS. And Heather, another clinic isn't scheduled yet, but now is the time for people to get on the waiting list.
Interesting story. Thanks, Megan. Up next, get the scoop on a fun getaway to Leavenworth. But first, here are some dates for your calendar. The city of Puyallup has been named the state of Washington's first age-friendly city. The designation comes from AARP and the World Health Organization. To celebrate the designation, the public is invited to a vendor fair at 9:30 a.m., followed by a ceremony at 10:30 and a workshop at 11. It happens on Saturday, May 14th at the Allied Health Building Theater at Pierce College in Puyallup. Learn how to grow your own food this summer at the monthly Edible Gardens Workshop Series. Classes are taught by educators from Pierce County Public Works and Harvest Pierce County. Free monthly classes are held in Puyallup, Lakewood, Parkland, Ording, and Tacoma. Go to piercecountywa.org/ediblegardens to register. This week, Jen Sargent has all of the details for signing up for Girls Fast Pitch. Hi, Jen.
Hi, Heather. With this warm springtime weather, it's a great reminder that it's officially baseball season. And now is a great time to sign up for our Girls Fast Pitch League. The league is open to girls ages 10 to 16. Play starts on May 31st and runs through mid-July. All 12 games are played at either Sprinker Recreation Center or at Heritage Recreation Center. The cost is $480. That fee includes all player and team fees, one dozen balls, and affiliation registration. Sign up by May 11th. It's almost time to hit the road and head to Leavenworth for Maifest. Our active adults group is taking a trip to the Bavarian town to celebrate spring on Saturday, May 14th. The van leaves from the Lakewood Community Center at 7 a.m. and will return at 8 p.m. The cost for this trip is $49. Call 253-798-4141 to sign up. You can find tons of great activities with Pierce County Parks and Recreation on our new summer activity guide. I'm Jen Sargent for Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather.
Nice hit. Thanks, Jen. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you can't find anywhere else. For more local focus, check out our website for news about your communities 24/7. Catch it at piercecountytv.org. I'm Heather Radall. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.